So, we already know some details about the Pixel 7, let's talk about it, and what I like to see. I mean, what better time to talk about this than now that the phone is probably already finalized. I'm gonna talk about the leaks we've seen. They're not recent, so maybe you've seen them, but if you don't like spoilers, I'm letting you skip this video, but make sure you're here for the next ones. Okay, it's just us now, and they look pretty similar to the Pixel 6 series. According to these OnLeaks renders, the 7 Pro will be about the same size as the 6 Pro, while the regular 7 will be slightly smaller than the Pixel 6. I'm kinda glad they didn't go for flat sides, these are big phones and being rounded makes them slightly more manageable. The biggest difference seems to be in the camera bump. It seems to extend from the phone's frame. If it's anything like what Samsung did with the S21s last year, I'm all for it. But I guess we're gonna have to wait until October, holy, it's gonna be a while. Anyway, camera setup seemed to be unchanged from the 6 series. Some people were hoping to see a telephoto camera on the regular 7, not one of those periscope ones like the 7 Pro will have, just the regular telephoto, but it ain't here. It would have been nice to see, but I think it's understandable if they keep the price of the phone competitive, which I hope they do for both of them like they did last year. By the way, those camera cutouts in the 7 Pro's bump look like the rumored iPhone 14 Pro's hole punch. Funny coincidence. The display will be curved on the Pro and flat on the regular 7, and that's pretty much it from these renders. There's also a different window for the millimeter wave 5G at the top. I kinda like the look of the old one better, but whatever. Oh, and I almost forgot, the bezels. They look slightly reduced, but not by that much to be honest. That's a small detail and these sort of renders don't always get everything right, so there's still a small chance we get even bezels all around, but it's very small given OnLeaks' track record. Design aside, I expect the Pixel 7 and 7 Pro to be pretty similar to the 6 series, just with the usual generational improvements. You know, Tensor 2, a better modem, that sort of stuff. They'll probably also get a better fingerprint scanner or an alternative like a simple face unlock, as many people complained about that. I didn't have any reliability problems with my fingerprint scanner, but it definitely wasn't fast, and that speed took a tumble after I installed a cheap glass screen protector, which, to be fair, has happened with every other optical fingerprint scanner I've tried, but, you know, I'll take every improvement I can get. I also expect the regular 7 to have a better screen than the 6. The screen on the 6 was gorgeous 99% of the time. When you're in the dark, you can notice some parts of the screen when it's not even, like it has some weird blobs. It's not that big of a deal, but it shouldn't have been in the 6, and I hope it isn't in the 7. It would be nice to see 120Hz coming down to the regular Pixel 7, even if it weren't with an LTPO display, which is better and is what the Pro uses, but I personally don't see it happening. Even with a lot of cheaper phones on the market already doing it, I don't think this is the year that'll happen. Also, the front-facing cameras on the 6 lineup weren't that great, so I expect them to be improved, at least for the Pro. Other than that, hopefully people won't have as many problems as they did with the 6 series on release. I ran into a couple of bugs here and there, which were mostly fixed back in December, so I didn't even experience them for long. And they were pretty minor when compared to what people were reporting, like problems with cell reception and high battery drain. That high battery drain was supposedly caused by 5G. And if you remember my review, at the time I didn't have 5G in my country. Well, I do now, but I can't get it on the Pixel 6, because it's not officially available where I live, and it's not compatible with my carrier. Seeing a wider release of the Pixel 7 would be nice. Overall, I'd call my experience with the Pixel 6 very positive. I've been enjoying it, and especially Android 12 a lot. It doesn't get in my way, it looks really good in my opinion with the new Material U designs and little animations, and it has some pretty cool Google added features. Just the other day, I was taking a screenshot of a page to translate it, and right from the screenshot floating thing, it offered to do it for me with Google Lens. Pretty neat. I moved into the Android 12 beta branch back when the March update was delayed, and I've been there ever since. It's pretty stable actually, haven't run into any problems, But I also don't really see a reason for most people to do this right now. It's still early to tell what Android 13 will bring, but I already love that they've been paying some more attention to the quick settings, which always had a ton of potential in my opinion. That new dialog to add quick setting styles automatically to your panel will be a game changer. And I'm sure they'll match Samsung with 4 years of Android version upgrades for the Pixel 7. I don't know if just matching Samsung is really what you want to see from the maker of Android and the Play Store, but that's a discussion for another day. It's still gonna be a long while until the Pixel 7s are official, but let me know what you think of them and what you want to see in the comments. The Pixel 6a is still coming before those, if everything goes as expected. Also looks very cool, by the way. And maybe we'll get some more details about the Pixel Watch and the Pixel Foldable. Anyway, that's all I had to talk about. I'll see you next time.